When you're driving down the interstate through the desert and you see a sign for some petroglyphs you didn't know about, do you go out of your way to see them? Well, of course you do. And that's what we did today on day 8 of this road trip. But that wasn't even the best part. Driving way down an obscure highway to the Mexican border and camping in Organ Pipe Cactus National Monument, aka America's most dangerous park, under an unbelievable sky was, for me, the highlight of this trip so far. Arizona offers surprises to anyone willing to explore it. At the hotel in Yuma this morning, we found a brochure about Tucson, where we'll be tomorrow, and I wondered what nighttime stars had to do with a hot, sunny part of America like this. As it turns out, we'll find out tonight. But this morning, it was time to leave Yuma, our home for the last two nights. Again, the only real option was Interstate 8. But really, in this part of the country, interstates and regular little highways are pretty similar anyway. Sometimes the views are really breathtaking, literally, like when you go around a bend in some rocky hills and suddenly you can see forever across the impossibly huge-looking Mohawk Valley. Plus, on either type of road, you might get to stop and make a new canine friend. On I-8 in Arizona, you pass through a desert landscape, past occasional exits that don't really seem to go anywhere. Some do, though. This one takes you to Dateland, home of an unlikely oasis of date trees. And another one goes to a rest area with its own name, Sentinel. On the way out, they stuck a nice big saguaro cactus on the on-ramp. It's the first of these we've seen on this trip. Roadrunner cartoons made real for a guy like me from Georgia, and a tantalizing taste of things to come tonight. It was around here, as we followed a train beside the road, or it followed us, that we saw the sign for Painted Rock Petroglyphs. So we took the unscheduled last-minute exit, bidding a cheerful farewell to the train, and drove a few miles further into the desert to Painted Rock. I've already made an in-depth video about Painted Rock petroglyphs, but for the purposes of this video, let me just say that the side trip was totally worth it. Besides the history, what I like about the place is the setting. It's in a wide, flat valley with long views to distant mountains in every direction. It feels like the middle of nowhere, because it is. A tall flag whipped in the wind, and I felt some admiration for the people who were camping for a day, or a few. The only thing here are the rocks, the snakes, and the other slithery beasts. The occasional cactus, and the severity and simplicity of the desert. Oh, and the hot sun. Bring sunscreen if you don't own a hat or hair. And we left, ending up a few minutes later in the town of Gila Bend, the first big town we saw after leaving Yuma. It's on I-8, and it must see a lot of people who pull off for food and gas and stuff, but Gila Bend definitely displays its own unique and quirky personality. Gila Bend is the subject of a song by the great band Los Lobos, and that's all the endorsement I need. We stopped in at the Space Age restaurant, which was established here by one Al Stovall, a NASA employee who joined the agency during the space race with the Soviet Union in the 1960s. This location in Gila Bend was one of five in the US. Inside the restaurant are murals dedicated to space, and more specifically, to astronauts and space exploration. Later on this trip, we'll be in alien-happy Roswell, New Mexico, so this is a taste of things to come. To paraphrase Mark Twain, road trip destinations don't repeat, but they do rhyme. Oh, and the food is pretty good too. I had breakfast for lunch, and Maceo had chorizo eggs. Chorizo sausage became an instant trip obsession for us. Highway 85 passes through the town of Ajo, which looks pretty cool with its colorful murals and bright, cheerful buildings. And it may be beyond the end of the world, but hey, it claims to have excellent burgers. Perhaps we can come back tomorrow and try some. Highway 85 also goes through a spot on the map called Y, and after that it's the only road between Y and Mexico. Now it's all rocks and cactuses and sunshine. And eventually it takes you even further past the end of the world to the far-flung Organ Pipe Cactus National Monument and UNESCO Biosphere Reserve. Having been stung by arriving at Joshua Tree National Park too late to get a campsite back on day 5, we'd phoned ahead at the Space Age restaurant and the ranger had said there would be plenty of camping. But we were still racing to get to the visitor center before it closed. Alas, as we pulled up, the rangers had just locked it up for the night and were taking the flag down. I chatted with one who gave me a map and told me the best place to catch the sunset would be the campground itself. Outside the Kris, Eggle Visitor Center is a little monument with a distinctive National Park Ranger hat. A plaque next to an organ pipe cactus explains the dark truth. In 2002, Ranger Kris, Eggle was chasing some drug smugglers who'd entered the park illegally from Mexico and was shot and killed, dying, as the sign says, in the desert that he loved. Even before this event, Organ Pipe Cactus was considered the most dangerous national park site in the US. It closed for a time and then reopened with more surveillance towers and patrols. Rough times in the untied states. Our friendly ranger gave us a park brochure with explanations of the plants and animals around Organ Pipe, plus the amazing factoid that the ground temperature in summer can reach 175 degrees. We thanked him and drove a mile or so to Twin Peaks Campground. And it was here that I first got to really use my new access pass. The cost for camping one night was $16, and you pay by the honor system, putting your cash in an envelope and dropping it into a slot, just like at the petroglyphs. Who knew I'd be spending all day sticking cash into the Arizona desert? And my new access pass meant we only had to pay half, $8. But still remembering the ranger's attitude at Joshua Tree about it, I rounded up to $10. So if you visit Organ Pipe someday and you notice that it's $2 nicer, well, you're welcome. We chose, I must say, an excellent campsite. Many of the others just had single-stick, no-arm saguaro cactus poles beside them, but campsite number 196 had a gorgeous one with arms. We set up the tent from Amazon for the first time, using hiking poles as the instructions suggest. It looked kinda shabby, and Maseo was very unimpressed, but unlike her, I thought it very well might hold through the night. We went exploring the area a little and found a lot of interesting plant life, like a cactus impersonating a rabbit raising its arm, and even a little animal life. Best of all, we encountered our first big organ pipe cactus in the wild. You can see its distinctive shape and why it's called an organ pipe. It only grows in this area of southern Arizona and northern Mexico. The uniqueness of the plant, its charming remoteness, and the beauty of the surrounding terrain are why this area was designated a national monument in 1937 by President Franklin Roosevelt. This text, by the way, is from the April 6, 1937 Federal Register, and I'd like to point out the comical grandeur of how the proclamation of the new national monument ends. In witness whereof, I have hereunto set my hand and caused the seal of the United States to be affixed. Well, aren't we something, Franklin? Thanks. You know, I have hereunto edited together a video about a road trip, and with an employment of my trackpad finger, have verily caused it to be uploaded to the tube of you. Nah, I'm just kidding, FDR. As I say, making this area a national monument was a great idea, and having visited the place, I personally think Organ Pipe Cactus should be upgraded to a full-fledged national park. It's awesome, and the ranger was right. The sunset from here was just fine. We cooked dinner at our campsite table while I checked my blood sugar and had a real outdoorsman's insulin shot. The bright sky slowly got darker, unbelievable clouds continued to roll across Organ Pipe, and the dying sunset morphed into a thrilling astronomy lesson, live and personal. Now, I was a novice, just learning about DSLR camera settings, and a lot of my photos came out grainy tonight. But even I couldn't really take a bad picture in this part of Arizona. Captured a bright, easily visible Big Dipper beside our cactus, the star cluster Pleiades just over the Sonoita Mountains to the west, Sirius, the brightest star in the sky, even brighter out here away from city lights, and Beetlejuice in the constellation Orion.
Just say it!
It'd have to be Beetlejuice. Betelgeuse, if you want to pronounce it.
You know, I've heard people say Betelgeuse, and I'm just like...
Really? Actually, it's Betelgeuse. Yeah, it's actually Arabic. And maybe I'm not even pronouncing it right, but it's definitely not Betelgeuse.
And countless others, points of light quadrillions of miles away, yet plainly visible here on a warm desert evening. And then we went to sleep in our ramshackle, translucent little tent. We slept well enough, but I would occasionally wake up throughout the night and note the moon's progress across the sky. I dug how the slow but steady pace of the cosmos complemented the patient serenity of the desert. Organ Pipe Cactus National Monument is definitely and infinitely worth the trip. Tomorrow we go on a dirt road drive through Organ Pipe to be amazed by cactuses in the morning light, go back and check out the towns of Y and Ajo, and take another unexpected side trip to a surprising mountaintop observatory, and encounter some wild animals on the road like I've never done while driving.